Sorry, welcome back to Blue Skies. I was having some audio issues. I did not hear anything. Anyway, let's jump into it. Hey, Yuri. I'm looking all over you. Yuri starts when I call out her name. Wednesday relaxes once she catches sight of me. I'm guessing that means startled. By the way, I'm on the newest version. I'm on 1.0.5. Anyway. Hope. Sorry. I was in the bathroom. Yeah, I figured as much when I didn't see I knew you weren't when I saw that you weren't in your classroom. Anyway, you wanna eat lunch with me? I'd love to. Come on, let's go down the roof. We start walking together down the hallway, our shoulders nearly touching. The backs of our hands brush together as we walk. Public skis are public displays of affection are strictly prohibited in our school, and Yuri's not one for breaking rules. Still, even the small touch sparks energy between us. I stealthily link our pinky fingers together, prompting a shy smile from Yuri. We walk together in companionable silence. Passing by the occasional student, hearing snatches conversation from within classrooms. Hope, isn't the stairwell to the roof on the other direction? Huh, I guess. I was following you. But I was following you. Leave it to us to do something like this. He walked all the way through the first tier classrooms without realizing what was happening. I suppose it discounts as our exercise for a week. Definitely. As we turn our head back, I notice Yuri just speaking to one of the classrooms. Oh yeah, shouldn't Natsuki's class be here? Mm-hmm. She's in class 1C, if I remember correctly. You want to say hi to her? Actually, couldn't even ask her to join, have lunch with us. Okay. It would be nice to talk to her some more. I can't recall the last time Natsuki and I had lunch together. Nice. I'll check to see if she's in there. In then. Sliding across some door open, I step inside with Yuri following closely. Inside, we're met with a few curious glances from those students. No surprise though, given that not many people know all their upperclassmen. Natsuki hunched over alone at her desk, scribbling something on the piece of paper. As we approach, we're surprised to see that rather than writing, she's drawing something. Hey, Natsuki, what you drawing? Startled, she looks up and quickly whips the paper off the desk. Yuri? Hope? What are you guys doing here? Just saying hi. Okay. Hi. What Hope meant to say is that we wanted to invite you to eat lunch with us. Oh. Sure thing. Not that I'm doing anything, anyway. I says that, she comes up her drawing and tosses it onto her desk. Whoa, what are you doing? I reach out for the ball drawing and find my arms being held back by Yuri. Huh? Yuri? Just leave her be, Hope. It doesn't seem right to me to just throw away hard work. Personally, I think I can relate to that feeling. To toss aside your own work because you dislike its imperfections, or simply because you're no longer in the mood. It's all part of the creative process. Yeah, that's spot on. Hope, you wouldn't understand true artists like Yuri and me. I roll my eye to that mark. Alright, whatever helps your belt. Still, wouldn't you want to be able to see your past work? Just like, see how far you've come? Yeah, but it's not like I trash every single thing I make that I don't like. Some things just don't work out. And to add to that, it's better to let some of your work go than rather constantly draw on its flaws. Mm-hmm. I guess I can see that. But it's almost suck to have your work wait time wasted like that. Eh, it's whatever. Why don't we just go eat now? Sounds good to me. We step out and make our way to the roof. It's nice to get some fresh air for once. The cool breeze rustles our hair for a bit. It's not too cold though. And the sunshine provides a warm comfort. Don't you get fresh air during the physical education period? I mean, yeah. But who likes PE? True. But wait, Natsuki. Where are you driving for? Oh. Nothing. Really? It looked like a bit of manga to me. Nazi's eyes flicker to Yuri for a second. Well, you're wrong. Hey, there's nothing wrong with it if you were. Lots of people are starting manga artists. Why do you think there's a manga club? Isn't that right, Yuri? I nudge Yuri in my elbow, with my elbow prompting a response from her.
What? Oh, I suppose so.
Nazi crosses her arms and looks away. Don't tell me she's gonna start pouting, pouting now. Desperately trying to silently communicate with Yuri through my facial expressions. Yuri mouths a question to me, but I try to answer it by pointedly looking at Natsuki. A look of understanding slowly dawns on Yuri's face.
Hope's right. Pursuing a career in the arts is nothing to be ashamed of. I may not particularly see the appeal of manga myself, but what I like and dislike isn't the end all be all of a subject. In fact, many people find my desire for a degree in Japanese and literature to be largely pointless. So, what I mean is, take pride in your interests.
Thanks for that. A genuine smile spreads across Natsuki's face as Yuri returns gratefully. But just so you know, it's not like I don't want to become a mangaka. It's just a hobby for now. Plus, I wasn't even drawing manga. It's just a character concept. Better than anything I could do, that's for sure.
Like, that's hard to achieve.
Fucking hell. Boy. Hey, it's not like I've ever taken art lessons before.
Neither have I.
Nancy's smile is soon replaced by a haunting, hearty grin of triumph. Looks like the old Natsuki's back.
Fuck.
And we got a good one. Meanwhile, Yuri chuckles at their antics.
Anyway, shall we sit and eat before lunch is over?
You bet, I'm starving.
Okay, Sayori.
Having settled down, he takes out her bento box and put on my own lunch out of my bag. Abbeens consist of extremely healthy options for two packaged breads. Yakisoba bread and my personal favorite, curry bread. As I tear open the curry bread, cellophane, I pause. Noxie's been sitting with her arms wrapped around her legs, making no movements to bring her lunch. Noxie's just staring into space. Hey, Natsuki, where's your lunch?
Huh?
She jumps up at my question.
I forgot it. Oh, did you leave it at your desk? We can go back for it if you like.
No, I meant I forgot it at home. She didn't check her bag for it. It's fine. Just don't worry about me. I toss my cocoa bread to her. Here. I don't know how much you like this stuff, but it's better than nothing. A look of, I don't know, shock? Surprise, maybe? Whatever emotion it is, it caused her eyes to widen up for a moment. How low an opinion must she have of me to be the surprise? Are you sure? Yeah, it's not like I'm gonna starve if I give it to you.
Okay, then thanks.
She enthusiastically tears the plastic package apart and chomps down the right noodles and bread. You just give breakfast that your favorite type of meal. At my question, Natsuki seems to choke at her bite for a second before easily chewing and swallowing.
I skip breakfast.
I think it's like a hungry day for me too. You know those days where you can never get full? I can relate to that.
The most likely result comes from an unhealthy diet.
Are you including me in that statement? Well, I can't argue against it.
I do not have an unhealthy diet. Okay, maybe I bake a lot of pastries for myself. But...
Looks like Natsuki's out of excuses. Just admitted, Natsuki. You're totally unhealthy. I mean, you don't play any sports. And you basically level off cupcakes.
Hey, I make other things besides cupcakes.
And the side, Yuri offers her bento to Natsuki.
You can't just be eating that for lunch now.
So here, so have some of mine.
Huh?
Really?
You don't have to, you don't want to. Yes, I'm perfectly fine with sharing my meal with you. It's a good thing I always pack an extra pair of chopsticks.
I'm fine. Hope already gave me some bread, so... like I said, don't worry about it. She would be a lot more convincing if it wasn't giving the if she wasn't giving the bento longing looks. Pretty good looking bento, don't you agree?
I mean, yeah, but that has nothing to do with me. I sure you don't want some?
Yeah, I am. Besides, I pick up Nazi's spirit chops and thrust them into Yuri's spirit chops and thrust them into Nazi's hands.
Hey, what?
If Yuri says you can, we can, alright? Yuri nods along with my words, affirming my statement.
Seriously, you're doing yourself a disservice if you don't try summer cooking.
It's all homemade and tastes exactly like how mother's cooking would taste.
My mom wasn't even that good at cooking.
Well, I don't know how motherly my cooking is.
But feel free to have some.
That is, if you actually want to try it.
It's not that I think it looks bad or anything. It's actually the opposite.
Bento looks really good.
Well, it does.
There's a wide variety sampling of side dishes to choose from, ranging from watercress to grilled mackerel. And as usual, Yuri's rice is perfectly fluffy with a simple... with a single umeboshi plum, keeping it fresh. I'm learning Japanese from this game. Thank you. Thank you, Minecraft. Why is it Minecraft?
Alright, so playing Minecraft last night. I was watching Walker play Minecraft and bullying him half the time.
Anyway. Really, it's no bother. I understand your reservations, but in the case they are unduly founded.
Okay, you insist.
By the way, do I get any too?
Sorry. Geez, Hope. You get to eat Yuri's cooking all the time, don't you? Stop pestering her about it.
Yeah, you're not pestering her, am I?
Yeah, you are.
Well, are you Yuri?
Are you Yuri? You're answering to her name. I don't have to be Yuri to know you are.
I'm not.
Are too.
At this point, you're probably the one bothering Yuri.
Nuh-uh, Yuri, what do you think? You're both acting like children. My apologize. My apologies. That was critically rude to me to say.
No, you're right. We're totally being immature idiots. I don't know what it's about Natsuki that made me act like a kid again. Probably a cutesy yet annoying attitude.
Maybe you, but...
Okay, it may have been a little bit, but I was just joking. Not my fault you can't tell when I'm being sarcastic.
Alright, I think that's enough.
Yuri suddenly picks up a piece of fish and chopsticks and shoves it in Natsuki's mouth. Natsuki kind of blows over in surprise, dropping her chopsticks in her lap. She shoots Yuri and Arcregius look, but dutifully chews on the food.
Huh?
Wow. My mouth suddenly filled with a taste of greens cooked in a savory sauce.
That's enough out of you. Too.
That's enough out of you, too. It appears that Yuri is finally realized what she's done.
Sorry about that. I don't know what came over me.
Now, that was really funny. Who knew that Yuri had that in there? I mean, as a boyfriend, I kind of knew.
Oh, shut up.
She jabs him aside.
Ow.
Anyway, I can't believe you did that, Yuri.
How could you be so cruel to your boyfriend of all people?
You deserved it.
Oh man, it was so out of character for you, Yuri.
But in a good way.
Really? I wasn't thinking when I did it. I don't know what to say. So I acted on impulse. It was so weird, wasn't it?
No, Nazi's right. It's nice to see your front side sometimes.
Yeah, it is how you act around when people when you follow your impulses. I think you should do it more.
Fun. It's not easy, you think, to get over my inhibitions.
Yuri mutters the last remark nearly inaudibly.
But I'm glad to see that I'm able to make others laugh.
She says with a gentle smile. By the way, that way it was super good.
Did you really make it yourself?
Mm-hmm. If you'd like, I could share my recipe sometime.
Heh, definitely. I can show you how to bake stuff too.
If you two combine your cooking and baking skills, you might call yourself the ultimate chef.
I don't know about that.
Laughing, we all dig back into our lunches again. This time with Natsuki sneaky bites at Yuri's lunch. soon enough that all the food's gone, save for a few crumbs. I'm fine too. As the bell rings, when I finish conveniently licking my fingers. Sorry, I have to do that for a few. That was fun. We should have lunch together again sometime.
I agree. I'm much more lively when more people are invited.
It's much more lively, shit. Well, don't get too clean now. We can still see each other at the club, you know.
Yes, I'll be seeing you two there later.
You betcha. That was quick. Man, I don't think I've ever been the first one in a club. That is, till now. Well, you're gonna be here with me. But she had to go to the bathroom again. Some girls have bladders of squirrels. Or maybe, there you wouldn't be.
God damn it, I'm born country.
You can't go one day without thinking that, could you? I know, it's right for me. To think that stuff when Yuri, or anything about Yuri. Wouldn't it do her injustice to not consider the hardships she goes through? Then again, I don't want to define her by self-harm. I have no idea what to think. Fortunately, my mental beratings are cut short by the rattle of the door opening. Oh, what a surprise. Didn't expect to see me here yet, huh? Nope, definitely not. Where's Yuri? She's usually with you, right? After all, you two are always watching the club together. Yeah. She's in the bathroom right now.
I'd feel kind of weird exploring to the bathroom and all.
You know that treat her like a fragile little flower, you know?
Yeah, I know that.
I'm once again reminded of the fact that I'm the only one who knows Yuri's secret. So, Monica may have a point. As I open my mouth to continue the conversation, the door slams open, announcing the arrival of Sayori and Natsuki.
Hi, Hope. Don't forget about Monica. Oh, and Monica too.
Welcome back to the club, you two.
Huh? Where's Yuri?
She's in the bathroom. Are you looking forward to discussing literature today? Something like that, I guess. Or in your case, it'd be more like discussing manga, huh?
Hey, manga is literature.
See, you're just on Natsuki's line. Shit. The script is corrupted. We gotta delete them.
Sorry. This isn't a joke. I don't appreciate people making fun of manga, especially when people like you who don't even consider what I'm saying about it.
Idiots. I don't see Natsuki. Classic Natsuki.
Hello, everyone. I apologize for my delay.
Whoa. Sayori suddenly materialized beside me. Where the fuck did you come from? It's fine, Yuri. You're not late. Not everyone's here. We can get the meeting started. As per usual, we'll have a bit of free time first, followed by poetry discussions and general announcements. Okay, everyone, let's get busy. We've been split up in smaller groups like that. With Sayori, with Monica leading the way by gently shuffling Sayori off to a corner of the room, and just me, Yuri, and Natsuki left. Out of the corner of my eye, I could see Natsuki open her mouth to speak before Yuri cuts in.
Hope, would you like to continue our novel then?
Natsuki turns away, brow furrowed in frustration. Hold on, Natsuki, were you gonna say something?
No.
I'm not interested in whatever stuffy book you guys are reading. She glances over Yuri as she says that.
I'm not sure how accurate my hunch is, but I got a feeling Natsuki wants to talk to Yuri more.
Come on, spit it out.
What happened to our lunchtime bonding?
That's none of your business. I wasn't even gonna talk to you.
Sorry if this is presumptuous. But did you want to speak to me and then?
Never mind. Small girl quickly spins around to flee the scene. I know Yuri wants to get on with the book that we're reading, but Natsuki seems pretty eager to talk to her. Should I hang out with Yuri, or encourage her to talk to Natsuki for a change? I have to admit, I'm reluctant to give up quality time with my girlfriend. But then again, I can read with her another time too, right? Get away. I need to make a decision before Natsuki hides away in her manga again. Okay, independence. And also, they're trying to be more friends, so let's wait. Because just in case, I choose a stupid answer again. Knowing Natsuki, she probably won't go. She's probably going to bottle this up and never going to talk about it again if we don't stop her.
So for the sake of one's sanity, it
Probably best if Shiri just talks to her for now.
Hey, Yuri, I think you should actually follow up with Natsuki. Do you not want to read today?
No, it's that I think Natsuki really wants to talk to you.
You have a point there. To be honest, I'm curious about it. Alright then, it was fine with you. I'll go speak to her now.
Go for it. I'll just do homework or something instead. Lord knows I need to work on procrastinating less. I wave Yuri off as I pull my bookworks out of with a sigh. I guess I'll be playing Monica today. I finished a particularly difficult math problem when Monica suddenly interrupts my concentration. Give my feelings of math. Can't say it's an unwelcome distraction, though. Okay, everyone, it's getting late, so let's hurry up and share our poetry. As I put away my homework, I print a sentence that appears before me. It's Yuri. But just about to speak to her, Monica interrupts me. Hope, you remember to write a poem this time, right? Monica says with a bright smile on her face. However, I can't help but hear the tiny edge on her voice. I don't think that's a smile. I feel like that's more like, I'm going to kill you. She's going to kill me. I'm going to fucking die. Anyway, man, why don't you girls get scary? That's what happens when you play Doki Doki Literature Club. They get scary really quickly. Yeah, I did. I hope I did you proud with it. We'll see. She's gonna kill me, isn't she? I pull out my poem and turn to Yuri, offering my handiwork. So, how'd it go with Natsuki? She pauses and takes my poem, clearly mulling over her words. Finally starts to speak with a smile.
Well, I can't say it went smoothly the entire time. She was quite evasive and prickly when I first confronted her. Although, there's no doubt my awkwardness factored to it. It may surprise you, but I don't think I've ever approached Natsuki on my own before. So, that doesn't even help matters either.
It's par for the course when it comes to Natsuki. But don't worry too much about it being awkward. As long as you're very well spoken in general.
Really? I wouldn't have thought of it so.
Really? Not downplaying your insecurities, of course, but I do think you overthink things a lot.
That might be an understatement. Anyway, after a bit, we began discussing topics such as our interests. To summarize, we just had a normal conversation. It was kind of a brainy conversation that people have every day, but somehow made me feel content.
Her eyes sparkle with life as she says this. That's understandable. After all, isn't a happy life usually made up of multiple small satisfying moments rather than a few large joyous moments?
You're right. All the things happening makes me wonder why Natsuki and I fought so vehemently in the past.
Part of it is because of the differences in approaches, though, right?
I suppose when two opposite opinions clash, two passion opposite opposing opinions clash, I'm stupid.
Absolute pandemonium ensues.
That's probably less outrageous. It's probably less outrageous than that.
Speaking of poetry, though, I think Monica's giving me the EOI, so do you want to start sharing?
With pleasure, Hope.
In any case, nice analysis today, Hope. Yeah, thanks. I've been learning from the best, so... You know, there's one thing I'm glad about when it comes to you and your dating. It makes my job as president a lot easier, a lot more people are enthusiastic about literature.
I'm pretty sure you've become more enthusiastic about it after dating her.
Wait, so you're not just happy for us as your friends? Well, that goes without saying. Thanks for your support, though. In the beginning, I wasn't really sure how it would be if two members of the club were dating.
No problem. To be honest, I had my own reservations about it before, too.
But it looks like everything turned out alright, right?
Yeah.
Well, yes, I hope so.
Anyway, it looks like everyone else is done by now, too. Do you want to reconvene with the others now?
Sure thing.
Okay, everyone. I hope we had good discussions today. It's really great to practice from our Japanese classes, you know. As you know, finals are coming up next month.
Natsuki and I instantly groaned. I relate too much to that one.
Don't remind me.
Yeah, there's still a whole month away. Something I'm worried about now. But the yellow bird catches the worm, right?
But what's the worm in this case?
I actually don't know. I guess it'd be good grades? Good grades, which lead you to be able to get a good university, thus find a well-paying, stable job. What's for that prevent you having to die alone without a family nor home? I think there's a bit of an exaggeration. Okay, if you don't like that idiom, how about this one? An ounce of prevention prevents an ounce of cure. A pound of cure. Okay, that's actually better in the idiom. And I assume the pound of cure will be failing grades, right? That's right. And we all know what our failing grades or exams lead to. Let me guess, living under a bridge and dying alone? You got it. Jeez, Monica, when did you become our mom? Plus, high school isn't even mandatory, you know. Plenty of people live normal lives without going to university, you know, too. I know. I'm just exaggerating. Sorry. I am just projecting my stress on everyone. Same! I do that every day! My voice cracked when I said that. That's sad. I definitely think that it's wrong to assume that the only path to career success is through higher education. All it does is oversaturate the job market with random degrees and buries young adults in $10,000 of debt. And at the same time, these young adults often don't know what they really want to pursue a career in. Some people might be better off at trade school or doing freelance work. I want to do freelance work. I want to be self-employed. Give me money. Buy my merch. No, really, I want to be self-employed just so I don't have to go vertical. I'm kidding. No, it's mostly so I can, like, play video games and get a tax exemption off them. I'm sorry. I was going for a memes line. Anyway. Pardon me, it is too forward. But there seems to be some cognitive dissonance at play here. Cognitive dissonance? You mean when someone believes in two different conflicting ideas? That's right. And you're actually right too. I don't think that people should be forced to go to college just to fulfill social expectations. Yet, I feel that pressure too. Of course, I want to go to university so I can get better myself. But there's always this pressure that's put in the back of my mind. Sorry, I'm looking at my email. I bought Undertale yesterday. $3, worth it. But there's always this pressure in the back of my mind. And now I know what my parents would do if I didn't go to university. So I guess all the stuff you said before about pressure being busy or true, huh? Natsuki, did you think Monica's lying about that? No, I thought she was just exaggerating. It's fine, Natsuki. Some of the stuff I say does sound far-fetched at times. Man. We really had to take you out on the spot, eh, Monica? Actually, everyone deserves a day of relaxation at this point. Especially you, right? A group spa day. My hope. Are you hoping for a spa with mixed baths? What the fuck? Just making sure. What? No! Damn. I can't stop thinking it. I can someone draw? No, don't answer that. Don't answer that. I was not going somewhere dirty. Shut the fuck up. I was not gonna say shit. I'm sorry. That was that was just me being funny now. Not funny, more of a little disgusting shit. That's... Yeah. I don't know. Anyway, I'm sorry, it's like still in my mind. Oh, where's my... There it is. Besides, Yuri's the only girl for me. Come on, Yuri. Let's show them all and go to mixed baths by ourselves. I need a drink.
Yuri's completely red in the face now. I really gotta remember not to make jokes like that around her.
Yeah. Don't do those kind of jokes. No.
I actually do those kind of jokes, just not around Yuri. Everyone else is just like, these two are just like nervously looking away like, we didn't hear that. Monica is laughing through the pain. Yuri is, well, she didn't write a face, but she's smiling, so. Maybe she's into it? Maybe. Like, pretty sure she's into it. Anyway. I'd rather have you not show us that.
Yeah, Hope. Don't be gross like that.
Sorry. Alright, let's get back on top before Hope makes Yuri implode out of embarrassment. I'm just smiling. I don't think she's embarrassed. She looks happy. Anyway. Hey, Yuri's not that embarrassed. Are you, Yuri? Let's talk about exams. Okay, never mind. She's embarrassed. I did tell her exam. Whoops. Yeah, I think I agree with that. Why would Nasi rather talk about exams, huh? Same here. Alright then. I don't know if I'm jumping the gun a bit, but I was thinking, how about we hold a few sessions together for exam prep? Aren't you forgetting the exams aren't for another month? They don't have to be held right now. We get together when they're closer to exam season. Personally, I believe holding a study session together would be a good idea. Between the five of us, each subject would have at least one person who's proficient in this area. But and that way, we could have those excel in certain areas, help those who struggle more in those classes. Yeah, I think that making a study group is pretty smart. It better help us motivate us more too. If we all support each other and cheer each other on. Huh. I don't have any objections to it myself. I like Siri said. It'll stop us from procrastinating. You mean stop you from procrastinating? This from the girl who can't get up. Oh, really, miss, I lost my workbook. Meanie, that's not even procrastinating. That's just me being absent-minded. Okay, but who's the one who rushed over to copy homework during lunch before? Oh, fine. I'll stop you and me from procrastinating. Happy? Why did it in Natsuki's voice? I meant to do it in the Sayori voice, which is more soft. Very. Hey, this is all very cool and whatever, but I think you're forgetting one tiny detail. I'm in the same year as you guys. There's no really point for inviting me to study group of mine, because I won't be able to help anyone with their work. But we can't leave you out. This is a club thing, and if you can help us study, you can provide emotional support. Yes, I don't really mind if you're with us. Rather, I'd actually like you to. We could all study and talk together. Even if we all study totally different subjects. And I suspect Monica feels the same way too. We can't go on banning a fellow club member and a friend like that. Yeah, what do you say, Natsuki? You joining us? Alright, fine. But only because you all dragged me along anyway. The wide grin on her face betrays Yuri's, Natsuki's true thoughts. Funny how at this point, we can all tell that she really means the opposite of what she says. Yay, I knew you'd say yes. Geez, nothing to cheer about. I'm glad that everyone's settled nicely now. Actually, that should be it for today. Thanks for all the hard work, guys. I'll see you guys tomorrow. I somehow feel exhausted already. To be honest, yeah. Hold on. I don't think we were planned for actual dates of our study session. Oh, thanks for reminding me. Let's discuss it in group chat so we can write down what schedule best fits us. We all make noises of information as we pack up our things. My nose is itchy. Studying the girls, huh? Well, then look, Yuri and Monica's influence will somehow pull up my grades. Not to mention, it'll be a lot more fun studying with friends. Although there's
There will undoubtedly be some disagreements when it comes to studying literature. Oh well, I'll be worth it in the end, right?
Maybe. Why is it?
I just got smacked.
Chicken!
Sorry, the chicken. It just smacked my foot. Anyway, thank you guys for watching this episode of Blue Sky. I don't know why I did that weird-ass voice. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.